Today we are going claw crazy. This is the honey badger claw. Let's check it out. How's it going, guys? Welcome back to Quinton's and the Gun Guys. So as stated previously, this is the honey badger claw. This is a South African design knife, but it's made in China like most things today, especially the coronavirus. So this is a knife which is probably one of the best sellers arguably in South Africa. And they are going global as well. So they do have a global footprint, especially in Australia and America, as far as I can see. So I finally gave in to buy one. Wasn't very keen when I initially saw them. I think it was about 5 years ago. But I finally gave in, everyone rambling on about them and raving about them. So finally decided to buy one and to review it. I've had this for a month. And as with all my reviews, I'll be going through any special features, things that I like about the knife, things that I don't like about the knife. So let's jump right in. The honey badger, let's go through construction first. So basically all the knives have the same basic construction. This is FRN scale, so this fiber reinforced nylon. The blade is 8CR13 MOV, but you do get a few different blade designs depending on your application or just the blade design that you prefer. But it's basically just the blade design that actually really differs with these blades. Otherwise, it's much of the muchness. So this comes in three different sizes. This is a medium, but you do get them in large and you do get them in small. So the blade that you saw right at the beginning of the video, that's the serrated blade, but I'll show you that down on my little table there so you can see a bit better. Further on, you get the large version of this knife for $699. You get the medium version for $749. And then you get the small version for $599. So there's not much difference in it, about 50 bucks between them. But that's for the 8CR13 MOV steel. If you want it in the improved D2 steel, it's going to cost you $1,000 for the medium flipper. So all of them are going to be flipper design, as you expect from the Honey Badger brand. And then it's a honeycomb pattern. So this is actually quite a grippy pattern. It's quite an ergonomic design as well, so I can imagine I've used this in the wet, but if your hands are full of something else which is slightly slippier, then I'm sure you're going to get a good purchase as well. You've got a bit of a finger quill there, so you know until where to stop sharpening it. I don't recommend ever using a blade like that with your finger there. I've just been nicked too many times trying that out. Not a big fan of that. It has a deep carry pocket clip. This one is not reversible. On some of the other blades they are reversible, this one isn't. But this is one of the older blades. I picked it up at my local gun shop, Hunters Heidelberg, for quite a good price. But as stated, this is probably one of the older knives in the range. There is some improvements in the new knives, like a reversible pocket clip if you want to carry it in a different pocket or different configuration. I quite like it in this pocket because I'm going to carry it left anyway, because in my right hand pocket I carry my Fox Knives Dart. That's my primary self-defense blade, but in the left pocket it works quite well, and I've used this as a everyday user. This is actually quite a nice knife as an everyday carry, everyday user kind of blade. But if you want to use it for self-defense, you can. So now for some close-up shots. So as stated previously, this is the plain edge or the smooth edge. This is my one. This is the medium-sized one. This is my wife's one. This is the serrated edged one. So as you've probably seen, that there's a bit of a size difference. So that's the size difference between the medium and the small. So that's about 50 bucks in it on the retail price. So there's not a big difference in pricing, but there's a big difference in size, and then the large one is even bigger. So this is the small one. So this is the one that I actually should have bought for myself as well. So it just fits a bit nicer in the hand, especially if you buy a karambit ring from Ultimate Edges here in South Africa. So that's local company manufacturing all kinds of nice things for these blades. They do the karambit rings, and they do the wave openers as well, which works quite nicely if you want that quick deployment out of your pocket. So what I quite like about this knife design is that it lends itself to very fine work. So if you compare it to this old Kershaw of mine, this Kershaw, so this isn't a very nice blade to work with. It's not very conducive to doing fine work. If you compare it to another Kershaw of mine, this blade, this is a sheep's foot. So this is very nice as well for doing very delicate work with the blade. So that's the same as this blade, which works quite nicely with that. There's a few different ways of opening up your blade. You can either do the little flick with the open in the back, or you can do the normal one-handed opening, nice and slow, or you can do that Spartaco flick, which works quite nicely as well, or you can do that Okapi flick and then flick it like that. Not always successful because it does hold on quite stiffly, but it does need some breaking in. Back to my face. As you've seen, this is a very smooth opening. You saw it quite nicely with the close-up. So what's nice about this is it has opposing roller bearings with 18 ball bearings in each of them. So it means that it's a frictionless design, which is actually quite a nice smooth action. You expect this action in a much more expensive knife, which this definitely is not. There's not a lot of competition in this price range. You are looking at other Chinese made knives as well in this price range. With your HDR 13 MOV steel. So this steel is infamous for being average. It's not a bad steel, but it's not a great steel. This is about the same as your Japanese Oz 8 steel. So it's not bad, but it's not great. It is still stainless steel. It has good corrosion protection. It holds a good edge, but it loses the edge quite quickly as well. But you can sharpen it quite quickly too. So two sides of the coin. It is good value for money. It's not the worst, but it's not the best. So this knife is basically a very good representation of being inexpensive but not being cheap. So there's a big difference between them. So now we're going to check out my unscientific test. I was just playing around with this knife, doing all sorts of funny stuff, but let's check that out now. So I want to check the practical application of this, checking how it goes through a shirt. What I did is I took an old shirt, I put it over a old box and see how it goes, and let's test it out. Very nice. Okay, next up is a sweet melon. Let's see how that goes. Okay, let's test it out. Yo, a slice through, no effort. Okay, so let's have some fun. So as you saw, not very scientific, but what is nice is how easily this cuts through a shirt. So if you ever want to use this in a self-defense scenario, you want to cut through someone's shirt, do some damage, then this is quite a nice blade for that application. I wouldn't recommend doing the serrated blade one. It might get caught on clothing, where this is probably just going to slice through, or it's easier to get out and do something else with it. So this blade design depends on what kind of style of knife defense that you prefer. So this comes down to probably your experience or what you like. If you like more flowing techniques, like you're getting Tai Chi, Kung Fu, anything like that in that direction, then you're probably going to prefer more flowing techniques like the Filipino martial arts, where this is quite nice for that. So this lends itself for flowing techniques nicely and for controlling body, controlling limbs, which is actually quite nice. I do recommend getting a karamed ring for that application if you want to. Just gives you slightly more control, like my Fox Knives Dart has. Nice little karamed ring there. I prefer a more direct approach. So again, your experience depends on, or what you prefer depends on your experience. So I've got a karate background and then Krav Maga as well. So I quite like the direct approach. That's why I like the stabbing blades. Direct approach, straight in, straight out. Like karate, like your Muay Thai, kickboxing, anything like that, that's a direct attack. even boxing as well. That's why I like a straight blade for stabbing. That's the same reason why I like this cold steel dart. Same thing, straight in, straight out. More of a puncture type weapon, not a slashing type weapon. So let's get back to the knife that I'm actually talking about. So as stated, I used it as an everyday carry knife. Used it, but I didn't abuse it. I've used this for a month, as I've stated. So as you saw, it cuts quite nicely through all kinds of fruit. This is quite a thick and solid carton. So it does a fairly good job of still cutting through it. So it is maintaining an edge very nicely. If I go to an A4 paper. Sorry, that's me. So it's cutting as you would expect. So I've just made a mess that my wife's going to probably kill me. So now that my mess is cleaned up, now I can get to the things that I don't like about this knife. So main thing that I don't like about this is it feels cheap. So that's my first impression when I first handled the knife. It feels cheap, but it does punch far above its weight. So this is actually quite a good value for money, I would say. Let's carry on with the things that I don't like. So getting to the pocket clip, those are super thin. It is probably going to break. I did ask in a group on Facebook, an everyday carry group, what the guys like and dislike about this knife. And the main thing that came up is that this pocket clip breaks off. So with slight abuse, it's probably going to break. So in the box, you get a knife, you get a Torx screw or a Torx Allen, and then you get a warranty card or a little catalog. Torx Allen key I tossed away. I stripped that trying to open this blade, just to oil it. I like oiling my blades before I really use them. Stripped that, tossed it away, so I'm back to just my normal toolbox Allen or Torx. Talks to loosen this. So that was a bit of a dodgy quality Allen. So it's not really a big list that I don't like about them. What's nice is the accessories that you get for them as well. There's a few local manufacturers that do sell aftermarket stuff for them. So I do recommend Ultimate Edges. They've got quite a nice range of all kinds of goodies, and he's an absolute wizard at customizing this. So this knife just lends itself to being customized. It's not very expensive, so if you mess it up, you're not going to cry over it. And then it is quite plain, so it just feels like it just needs some extra oomph. I like this spine as well. This is quite thick, so I might do a bit of a vine filing job on this. So just watch the space. I might play around with this and then might customize this myself. So let's see how that goes. It's definitely not going to be the same quality work like Ultimate Edges. If you want to customize a knife, rather send it to them. They're probably going to do a much better job than you are going to do yourself. Now, for a verdict, do I like this knife? Well, I like it enough to buy my wife one as well. So that's going to be her everyday carry now. I am going to customize it, get some stuff as stated earlier from Ultimate Edges. Just to be a more effective, maybe self-defense type of knife for that quick deployment, because it does take a while getting out and then deploying it normally. I was almost on my toe. Ouch. Anyway, let's carry on. Bit of a cold sweat there. So, like it or not, this knife is good value for money. You really can't knock it. There's nothing in its class that I would say is really competitive for it. There might be ones that I really don't know about, some other brands that's lesser known in the South African market. So like it or not, this is good value for money. It is going to be an easy carrier, and just for the action as well, I can sit there the whole day just doing this. This gives me such joy, and I don't know why. Thing to note as well, and it does need some breaking in. So this is a very solid and sticky liner lock, but it does get better the more you use it. This knife was super sticky. It didn't really release easily, but it's releasing a lot easier now and then flipping easier as well. And that's it, guys. That's the Honey Badger Claw. Hope you guys enjoyed this video. Hope it was informative. This is one of my favorite subjects, knives. I've got a big thing for knives. So if there's another knife in the South African market that you think I should review, maybe another Honey Badger, maybe something else, maybe more in the budget range, or maybe more expensive, please hit me down in the comment section. Please like, share, subscribe, all those nice things. Have an awesome week, guys. Cheers.